We begin tonight keeping them honest with a stunningly cruel statement by a White House aide, eclipsed only by the new stunningly evasive White House response to it, if you can even call it a response. Kelly Sadler is a White House special assistant who handles surrogate communications. She told staffers during a meeting that Senator John McCain's opposition to Gina Haspel as CIA director doesn't matter because, quote, he's dying anyway. That is according to a White House official who said she meant it as a joke, but it fell flat. We would hope so. Senator John McCain is an American patriot, a war hero. He served his country. He was held in captivity, survived torture. But even if he wasn't any of that, he's a human being battling incurable brain cancer. And as his wife, Cindy McCain, tweeted to Sadler, quote, may I remind you, my husband has a family, 7 children, 5 grandchildren. A source says Sadler called Meghan McCain yesterday to apologize. We don't know what her response was. But on The View today, Meghan McCain said, don't feel bad for her or her family, that they're strong, there's much more love generated toward them than anything negative, and that her father is doing well right now, which we are very glad to hear. But there is one thing she says she doesn't understand.
I don't understand what kind of environment you're working in when that would be acceptable, and then you can come to work the next day and still have a job.
At the White House today, multiple reporters tried to ask this multiple times. Watch.
Does she still have a job?
I'm not going to comment on an internal staff meeting.
Does the White House not think that you need to condemn these remarks or comment?
Again, I'm not going to validate a leak one way or the other out of an internal staff meeting.
Are you saying that she didn't say this?
Again, I'm not going to validate a leak out of an internal staff meeting one way or the other.
Does Kelly Sadler still work at this White House?
Yes, she does.
So the only thing Sarah Sanders would directly answer is that Kelly Sadler does still work at the White House. No condemnation of the remarks, no acknowledgement that they even happened. Sanders seemed more concerned that the remarks leaked than that they were said in the first place. So the problem is not that a taxpayer-funded representative of the president said something hateful. It's that we all know a taxpayer-funded representative of the president said something hateful. Not to mention the fact that the press secretary's Nothing to See Here act is hard to swallow, given that we've all seen it. John McCain's wife and daughter have talked about it. Kelly Sadler called to apologize. Why can't this White House do the same? Perhaps it's because the president also has talked trash about Senator McCain. Remember when he said he liked war heroes who weren't captured? The president's behavior, past and present, seems to render this White House incapable of apology of any kind, even when it's obviously the right thing to do. Again, multiple reporters tried to address this today multiple times.
What does the White House believe about Senator McCain? And is there a tone set from the top here where it is allowed for an aide to say he's dying anyway?
Certainly, there is not a tone set here. We have a respect for all Americans.
Why not just apologize to Senator McCain?
Again, I'm not going to get into a back and forth because, you know, people want to create issues of leak staff meeting.
Does the president set the tone? Does he bear responsibility for the tone within this White House?
The president, as I mentioned just a moment ago, supports all Americans.
So, according to Sarah Sanders, the president has not set a tone. He respects all Americans, supports all Americans. Here's just a small sampling of Donald J. Trump respecting and supporting all Americans, starting with American war hero Senator John McCain.
He's a war hero.
5.5 years.
He's a war hero because he was captured. I like people that weren't captured, okay? I hate to tell you.
Maxine Waters, a very low IQ individual.
Well, Rosie O'Donnell's disgusting. I mean, both inside and out. You take a look at her, she's a slob.
You know what they used to do to guys like that when they were in a place like this? They'd be carried out on a stretcher, folks. Like to punch him in the face, I'll tell you.
You had some very bad people in that group,
but you also had people that were very fine people on both sides.
When you're a star, they let you do it. You can do anything.
I moved on her like a bitch.
Believe me, she would not be my first choice, that I can tell you.
I don't know what I said. I don't remember.
As the First Lady said at the beginning of this week, be best. Senator John McCain is among the best. We wish him and his family the best. CNN's Jeff Zeleny was at that White House briefing today. He joins us now. Jeff, once again, Sarah Sanders avoiding answering questions and also standing by Kelly Sadler. Does it seem like there will be any repercussions for these comments?
John, I think it's clear there will not be repercussions from these comments. I mean, and I'm not sure that Sarah Sanders avoided answering questions. She did answer the question, saying she's not going to talk about it. That in and of itself is an answer. That was the answer today from the White House. They were not going to apologize. They were not going to give an inch on this, which seems something like, you know, an easy thing to do. Republicans on Capitol Hill I talked to today were a little stunned by this. After that White House briefing, watching Sarah Sanders calling this an internal matter, so I was trying to ask a question there to get around the apology thing, you know, saying a tone is set for the top. Is anyone off limits here? Is there any sort of sense of decency here? But the reality here is that the president does set the tone from the top, and the tone set today was to not apologize. The question here is whether that was a direct order from the president or if people were trying to please the president by not doing so. I don't know what the answer to that question is, John.
You know, and it does certainly seem, Jeff, that Sarah Sanders was more concerned about the fact that this hateful comment from this taxpayer-funded employee leaked than the fact that this taxpayer-funded employee said it in the first place.
I was struck by that, actually, listening to those answers several times, saying this was a leaked comment. Sure, it was leaked, but the reality here is that the employee apologized herself. She called Meghan McCain last evening, offering a private apology, and she was at work today. She was doing her normal business. She was sending out emails. She's a surrogate coordinator. What that means is that she sort of tries to get Republicans and supporters on the same message here. She was doing that today as business as usual. So it was an internal matter that leaked, but I was so struck, John, as we end this week here, the White House treated it as just one more attack on them, as opposed to what it actually was, an attack on John McCain.